Thanks, Brooke. President Trump arrives at Mar-a-Lago for what will be day 106 at one of his own properties since taking office in January.
Wow.
The lead starts right now. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, but behind the scenes at the White House, it's Festivus, and the airing of grievances has begun. A historically unpopular president spending 20 minutes talking about how great this year has been for his administration, but with so many thorny issues outstanding, unresolved party infighting, and both chambers of Congress in jeopardy, are Republicans actually terrified about 2008? And you have to be on the list if you want to get past the velvet rope. Ambassador Nikki Haley backing up her threat to punish U.S. UN countries that voted against the U.S. on its move of its embassy in Israel. He's hosting a very exclusive friendship party. Only the 9 countries that voted with the Trump administration got invited, though they have a plus 35 for the abstentions. Most liberal democracies, well, they made other plans. Plus, candidate Trump promised to get rid of the EPA, so only tidbits remained. Well, it looks as though he's on the right track at the agency that's charged with protecting human health and the environment. Scientists and staff are leaving in droves. What might that mean for our health? Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to The Lead. I'm Jake Tapper. As President Trump and Republicans head into the holidays, they're trying to put a proud face on the state of their party going into the midterm election year. The president spent the morning touting the GOP's historically unpopular tax law and predicting that both parties will start working closely together. But behind the scenes, Republicans are attacking each other and terrified of what might happen in the midterm elections in November. They are worried that an increasingly unpopular president and a series of missteps could see them removed from power next year. My panel is here with me to discuss all of this, but I want to start with CNN's Sarah Murray. And Sarah, the blame game and the second guessing, it's already begun.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. Look, we know even the president's own allies outside the White House have warned that, great, you passed tax reform, that's a big accomplishment. That's not going to be enough to save your party's control in 2018. We know the leadership in both chambers. We've been talking about the House, concerns about keeping the House. Now that has moved to the Senate. Control of both chambers leadership is concerned, and we know that Ronna McDaniel, who is the head of the RNC, was handpicked by the president for that role, sent a memo to John Kelly, this is according to Politico, warning him, look, the party's support with female voters is collapsing. This is a real problem. So yes, the president got his tax reform win, he's sort of riding that wave of victory, but it could be short-lived, and we could see Republican infighting starting as soon as January when they had this whole list of priorities they kicked down the line come to fruition.
Also, lots of other reports, McConnell versus Steve Bannon, Corey Lewandowski lashing out, telling the president he's not being served well. Is the message getting across at all to President Trump?
This is a great question. You would not think that the president was particularly concerned if you were watching him today. Listen to him tout his legislative accomplishments.
Our country is doing very well. We've tremendously cut regulations, legislative approvals, for which I'm given no credit in the mainstream media. We have, I believe it's 88, which is number one in the history of our country. Second now is Harry Truman. Harry Truman had more legislative approvals than any other president, and a record long held. And we beat him on legislative approvals, for which I get no credit.
Now, his math may be wrong about his legislative achievements versus Harry Truman's, but this gets to the heart of one of the president's core grievances, which is he believes he has actually been very successful, and he's not getting credit. And there are people around him who think this is someone who needs to be more concerned about what 2018 could hold for control for his own party. And we are seeing the RNC begin to ramp up already because they're worried. They're worried about keeping control, too, and they're trying to form a message for Republicans to run on that isn't just tax reform, but his economic growth and his judicial nominations. It's just not clear if that's going to be enough.
All right, Sarah Murray, thanks so much. Let's talk about it with our panel. Let's start with the infighting between McConnell and Steve Bannon. McConnell got an opportunity today to hit back at Steve Bannon, who has declared war on him. Take a listen.
Do you blame Steve Bannon for Doug Jones being elected in Alabama?
Well, let me just say this. The political genius on display, throwing away a seat in the red state in America, is hard to ignore.
And that's pretty harsh, Bill. The political genius on display for throwing away a state in the